Today we will be showing you how to replace a tape drive in a Dell TL2000 and TL4000 tape library. This procedure will apply to all drive types. This means both full-height drives and half-height drives, and all interface types, meaning SCSI, fiber channel, and SAS. Downtime will be required for this replacement and should be scheduled with the system administrator prior to powering down the library. The first thing that you will need to do is identify the drive or drives that need to be replaced. This can be done in one of two ways. The first is from the front control panel of the library. In the lower right-hand corner, you will see all of the drives listed by number in the library. Each number will have a symbol underneath it. If the symbol underneath the drive is a check mark, that means that the drive does not have an error. If there is an exclamation point under the number, then that drive does have an error. Please note, the drives in this library are numbered from the bottom up when looking at the rear of the library. This means drive 1 is the bottommost drive and they are numbered consecutively up from there. The second way to identify a faulty drive is from the web GUI. After logging into the web GUI, you will see the Library and Drive Status window on the right-hand side of the screen. This status window will list the current status of all drives in the library. These are in the same number order as they are listed on the front control panel. If a drive is healthy, it will have a green check mark next to it, and if there is a fault on the drive, it will have a yellow exclamation mark next to it. Please note, if you have drives that have a SCSI or fiber channel data connection, then you will need to also know the SCSI ID or worldwide name, respectively, of the drive or drives you are replacing. This doesn't apply to SAS drives, as they can only be directly connected to the host and the SAS address is not malleable. You can get the SCSI ID or worldwide name of the faulty drive either through the front panel or through the web GUI. Through the front panel, hit the Enter button to get into the main menu. Then go to Monitor, and then Drives, and then Identity. Select the drive with the error from the list, and then use the minus button to go down to the second page where it will display the SCSI ID or worldwide name of that drive. Do this for all drives you are replacing. From the web GUI, go under Monitor Library and then Drive Identity. Locate the faulty drive or drives in the list and ensure that you notate the SCSI IDs or worldwide names for all drives that you are replacing as they are displayed in the information listing for that drive. Once you have identified the position of the faulty drive or drives, you will need to power down the library. Please be advised, the maintenance manual for this library states that you can simply put the drive offline and replace it with the library still powered on. However, in our experience, this procedure more often than not will cause the library to freeze completely and require a reboot, so our best practices are to schedule downtime and power the library off to replace the drive or drives. To power down the library, press and hold the power button for 4 seconds. You will see a message pop up on the front panel stating that the library is powering down. Release the power button and allow the library to power down completely and the screen will go dark. Go around to the rear of the library and locate the power cords. Unplug them from the back of the library so as not to cause any electrical charge that may damage any components of the library while you are replacing the drive. Once the power cords are disconnected, locate the faulty drive or drives in the library and label the data cables going to them with their positions. Once all cables are labeled, disconnect the data cables from the faulty drive or drives. Then you can undo the thumb screws that hold the drive or drives in place. If you are replacing a half-height drive, there will be 2 thumb screws, one on each side of the drive. If you are replacing a full-height drive, there will be 4 thumb screws, 2 on each side of the drive. Once all thumb screws are loosened, you can pull the drive or drives straight back and out of the library. You are now ready to install the replacements. Carefully line up the replacement drive with the black guide rails in the empty drive bay. Slide the drive in until you feel it make contact with the backplane of the library. Then push firmly to seat the drive completely and tighten down all thumb screws, securing the drive in place. Follow this same procedure for all drives that you need to replace. Now reconnect all data cables going to the drives you replaced. Plug in all power cables to the library, and then go around to the front of the library and hit the power button once to power the library on. The library will now initialize. This will take 5 to 10 minutes depending on if it is a TL2000 or a TL4000. When it is finished initializing, the library will display idle RAND or idle SEQ in the lower left-hand corner. At this point, you need to ensure that all drives listed in the lower right-hand corner have check marks under them. Alternatively, you can look in the web GUI of the library and ensure that all drives have a green check mark next to them in the status box. If the drive you replaced has a SCSI data interface, you will now need to set the SCSI ID to the same as the faulty drive. To do this from the front panel, go to Configure, Drives, Drive Interface, and then select the drive that you replaced and hit Enter to change its SCSI ID. When you are finished, hit Save. If the drive you replaced has a fiber channel interface, you will need to get the worldwide name of the replacement drive. To do this from the front panel, go to the main menu and then select Monitor, and then Drives, and then Identity. Select the drive you replaced from the list and then use the minus button to go to the second page and view the worldwide name of the replacement drive. You will need to give both the original and replacement worldwide names to the person who administrates the fiber network, if the drives go through a fiber switch before going to your host system. This way, the administrator can update any zoning as needed. You may still have a message on the web GUI that says Media Attention or an amber light on the front panel of the library. When a tape drive goes bad, it will usually start marking tapes as bad within the library. Unfortunately, the TL2000 and TL4000 are not smart enough to know that the drive has been replaced and that the tapes are actually good. So at this point, you will need to remove any tapes that the library has marked as bad in the web GUI and allow the library to inventory itself without those tapes. Then, the media attention error should go away. While the library is inventorying itself, you should take time to physically inspect any tapes that you removed that have been marked as bad. You are looking for any physical issues with the tapes that may have caused any errors. Once you have verified all tapes, you can reinsert them normally into the library. You will now need to reconfigure your backup software to be able to use the drive or drives you just replaced. All backup software handles this process differently. For our purposes, since we use Symantec Backup Exec, we simply need to restart the services to allow the tape services to detect the replaced drive or drives. Your backup software procedure may be different. Any questions should be directed to your software support or manufacturer. If you are still seeing an error on the drive after replacing it, or you have any other issues, please open a ticket through the Rocket Plus customer portal.
Thanks for watching. This has been another video by the Top 10 USA Video Production Team. We look forward to sharing more content with you going forward, so please check out our YouTube channel and please subscribe so that you get notified whenever we release a new piece of content.